we're going to talk about everything new in Command. Redesigned dashboard,
home and login screen,
quick action links,
a brand new profit share dashboard widget,
lead management,
connect,
notification preferences,
import contacts directly from your phone,
create brand new custom tags while you're working on the go.
Make sure you subscribe and hit that bell icon to never miss out on future content.
Here we go. Let's dive right in first with our redesigned home and login screen. You'll see here, once you enter in your login credentials, you'll be taken to the brand new redesigned dashboard, bringing in some additional functionality, helping surface the most important information to you right away. Right across the top, you're gonna see quick action links. Any new leads that you haven't contacted yet. Everyone who's been active on one of your consumer experiences, whether that's your agent site or your mobile application in the last 72 hours, then what upcoming birthdays and home anniversaries you might have within your database. We also brought a brand new profit share dashboard widget. Here in the top right-hand corner, you can click on customize and reorganize your entire dashboard to meet your preferences by first selecting which widgets do you actually want to appear here. And then on the right-hand side, dragging and dropping those in order that you'd like to see them appear. I'm gonna bring my profit share widget right here to the top underneath new leads to claim. Then I'm gonna click apply in the bottom of the screen. Now, I'm gonna see that brand new profit share widget relocated in my dashboard where I can easily find it every time I log into Command. Next up, we're going into lead management. This is all about making it easier for teams and solo agents to manage leads that are coming into Command. Let's start first here in the team side where I'm gonna click on my name, I'm gonna go to settings. Then over on the left-hand side of the screen, I'm gonna go to Command Settings, Contacts, and Lead Management. Now for Teams, this was previously called Lead Routing. We still have all of the same feature set available for Lead Routing, and we've added in some additional tools where we've renamed it to Lead Management as a complete experience. I'm gonna create a brand new route here right in the top right-hand corner. And this route we're gonna do for social ads. I may be running social ads through campaigns and I wanna be able to route those leads to various members of my team. I'm gonna say social ad weekday. We're going to do these in a round robin rules type. You can always hover your cursor over the little I right next to that name to see a full definition of that specific routing rule. Because this is my weekday, I'm also going to make sure I only have my weekdays checked. So I'll remove Saturday and Sunday. I'm gonna keep all times and I'm gonna increase my claim action deadline to 5 minutes. So every time that a lead is offered to an agent on my team, they'll have 5 minutes to claim that either from the Command app if they're working on the go or right here through that desktop bell icon notification. I'm gonna go next. Now I'm gonna choose my lead source. I'm gonna choose the Facebook ad lead since that's the social leads that come through our campaigns applet. Then I'm gonna click the next option right here. Next, I'm gonna choose which agents do I want to include in this round robin lead route. We're gonna have Avery, David, myself, and then we're also going to have Mike. Before you move on from the agents tab, the round robin rule type, you're gonna wanna make sure that each agent on the team has a unique position number. I'll go ahead and say we'll have Avery be number one. We're just gonna do these right here in order. 3, and number 4. Now I can just click the next button in the bottom of the screen to go to the last step, the new lead rules, completing the lead management experience. What tags do I want to automatically have added to a contact when they come in? Maybe I want to add a brand new tag called social ad. Here, I'm going to choose the color that I want it to represent. Then I'm going to click add tag. I can also auto assign a smart plan. Maybe I want to choose my 8x8 for new contact engagement. Now I can press save at the bottom of the screen and all of my future social ad leads that match this rule type are going to go through this round robin rule setting. Let's take a look at what this looks like for a solo agent. You're going to have the same lead management settings except for routing to multiple agents. In your personal settings, you'll be able to go to contacts and go to lead management. For this one, I'm gonna create a brand new rule in the top right-hand corner and I'm gonna call this one agent site registration. Which lead sources is this for? You can select all, or I'm gonna say my KW app or site, that's gonna be my mobile app or my consumer agent site. I'm gonna check that off. Then I'm gonna create a brand new tag. Then I'm gonna choose which smart plan. I'm gonna use this custom smart plan that I created called new agent site registration.
Now, moving forward, anybody who registers on my agent site will be automatically tagged and automatically start on my new agent site smart plan. Let's move on to our next update. I'm gonna go back to our home screen and we're gonna go to the middle tab here at the top, Connect. Connect is a new experience for us to engage in content created by our Keller Williams University team. Here, you can search for content in the top bar right here, like playbooks. When I search for playbooks, I can see here all of the playbooks that we released at Family Reunion in 2023. You can click through on these individual pieces of content, see all of the assets that are included. I can even bookmark them to save them to my profile so the next time I visit the Connect page, I'll be able to go right to all of my bookmarked or saved content. Here, I can open up any individual playbook like the Open House playbook. I can scroll through all of its content here, or I could even download this and save it right on my computer's hard drive. I'm gonna click on the KW logo in the top left-hand corner for learning, and we're gonna go to this next applet, Events. This is where you're going to be able to find a collection of our KWRI, both national events and our exclusive trainings by the Keller Williams University Tech Training Team. You can search for events right here at the top, or you can scroll through all of the available listings. Next up, we're gonna take a look at notification preferences. Here in the top right-hand corner, I'm gonna click on the bell icon. Then I'm gonna go right here to the gear icon. This is going to take me through to my notification preferences, where I'm going to see a variety of categories like admin, campaigns, command email, consumer, contacts, KW, opportunities, recruits, referrals. I can click into any of these categories, like referrals, and individually control what type of notifications I receive and where do I receive them. Do I want to receive them as a desktop in-app notification, which would be right here in my bell icon? Do I want it to be a mobile in-app notification? Or do I want it to be a mobile push notification where I actually get that active alert? Keep in mind, we have these great tool tips for you to help branch out that definition of each notification type. And you can go through and check off any changes that you'd like to make, remembering to save them using the save button in the bottom right-hand corner. In addition to that, if you want to make sure that you're turning on all notifications for a particular category, you'll want to use the quick actions button in the top right-hand corner, where I can use that drop down to choose, do I want them all on? Do I want them all off? Or maybe I want to reset them to the default settings that were originally here. Anytime that you're using one of the quick actions, it automatically is going to save and you'll see that notification as it appeared in the bottom right-hand corner. I want to share with you a couple of ways the Command app can help you work on the go. One of the biggest updates in the newest version of the Command app is the ability for you to import contacts directly from your phone to Command. Here, the first thing I'm going to do is confirm that I'm in the right account. If you're an agent on a team, in the top left-hand corner, you can click on your name and you can switch between your personal account or your team account. That's just going to determine what account you're importing the contacts into. I'm going to keep my team account selected here and I'm going to click on the Contacts applet in the bottom menu. Then I'm gonna choose import in the top right-hand corner. Here, I see a confirmation. I'm going to be importing contacts to my team account and I can confirm with continue. Next, I can select the contacts that I'd like to import. I see the total number of contacts on my phone in the top right-hand corner and I have the easy option of just selecting all if that's what I wanna do. I can also clear that selection and maybe search for a specific contact. Or maybe I want to scroll through and select contacts from this menu in alphabetical order. Now in the top right-hand corner, I see that I have 4 contacts currently selected and I can move forward to the process by clicking continue. Now, once I click continue here, it's going to start the import process and it's going to keep me updated throughout the entire time. It's going to change based on the number of contacts that you import. The larger amount of contacts, the longer the import process could take on your phone. Now, it's also going to check for duplicates. Just like when you're adding contacts into Command, we want to make sure we're helping you keep the cleanest database possible. Liz Moss here was not able to be imported because it was found as a duplicate. I can go ahead and press OK. It's going to complete the import process, and now I can continue working inside of Command. With another update that was brought to the Command app, the ability for you to create brand new custom tags while you're working on the go. I'm gonna go ahead and choose a contact here, Ashley. Now with Ashley in the top right-hand corner, I'm gonna go ahead and click on that add remove tag section. Here's where I can uncheck to remove any tags that I currently have existed, or I have the ability of creating a new tag right there at the top of the screen. You can title the tag whatever you'd like, and then even choose a corresponding color that you'd like for it to be represented. Now, after you've created your tag, you can click continue in the top right-hand corner, and it's gonna not only add that tag to your existing tag database, it's also going to add it right to that contact record. So all you have to do is tap done, and you've completed the process. The team's already hard at work and bringing even more value to Command and the Command app next month. See you next time.